The drilling project that we're undertaking is a three-phase process, and the rig that we have is the one that we use for the second phase of the drilling experiment. It's a typical drill rig that's used in minerals exploration industry, and it's drilling into what's known as the basement rock, which is the same hard rock that you see on all the hills around the place here. That drill rig at present, it's using a drill bit known as a polycrystalline diamond bit. So it's got all these teeth on it, and it's chewing its way through the rock, and it's just creating chips known as cuttings. So the bit's down there in the ground chewing up the rock, and up above it we have a whole lot of circulating fluids, and these chips of rock get caught up in the fluid and then they're brought to the surface, and you can see this outflow of mud that's occurring, and in it are all these little chips of rock that are entrained. So our geologists will go up to the rig. They'll take those cuttings and they'll wash them. Then we take that material and we split it up. We separate out the quartz chips, that's the white coloured chips, and we have a representative sample that doesn't have the quartz chips. Those two samples are passed on to the thin section preparation team. A thin section is a sliver of rock that is a thickness of 30 microns, that's 30 thousandths of a millimeter. And it's so thin that if you pass light through it, you can actually see through it. And it's a method that geologists typically use to identify different minerals that make up the structure of a rock. In our case, it's really important that we have those thin sections so that we can work out which part of the rock sequence we're in. There are some really diagnostic minerals and some really diagnostic shapes to the minerals that are going to tell us where we are. We expect the rock to change character a little bit as we approach the Alpine fault. That's because the Alpine fault is shearing this rock at depth, and it breaks up the minerals, it makes them into finer grain sizes, and it changes the way they're arranged. And based on what we can observe in terms of this, the grain size and the arrangement of the minerals, that tells us as geologists how close we're likely to be to the principal slip surface of the Alpine fault. And there's a point at which we can tell we're going to be about 300 meters above the principal slip surface of the Alpine fault. And at that point, that is the basis for our decision to switch to coring, which is the third phase of the drilling process. Lots of people hope, and I'm sure we all hope, that someday we'll be able to predict earthquakes. But I don't think that's the most realistic thing that geologists can offer New Zealanders or the rest of the world. It's realistic that we can help people to understand what ground shaking is likely from the next earthquake. What's the hazard scenario that I have to be prepared for personally? What is likely to happen at my house or at my workplace? If you know what's likely, then you can be prepared for that. The kind of research we're doing here is really important because the processes that happen, like fracturing of the rock, they change the kind of earthquake that is going to be generated. What we are doing in this project in particular is we are helping to understand what are realistic earthquake scenarios. That's really important for New Zealanders to understand what's possible so that they can be prepared, and our whole society, our emergency management, the people that legislate how houses are built. We can do that kind of design, that kind of planning as appropriately as possible.